That is a perfect landing. The problem is, it's 4,000 feet down the runway. Do this on a short runway surrounded by water, and you make your flight into a cruise. The passengers may not like that kind of a cruise. So where's the ideal spot we want to land on? And what do all these markings mean on a runway? Threshold. We will use San Francisco's runway 28 right for this demonstration. We will start with a threshold. It will have longitudinal stripes of uniform dimensions about the runway centerline. They can have up to 16 stripes to indicate runway width. 4 stripes equals 60. 6 stripes equals 75. 8 stripes equals 100. 12 stripes equals 150. And finally, 16 stripes equals 200. Runway designators. Runways are aligned with the most predominant approach direction. This number is taken from the nearest 1/10 of the magnetic azimuth measured clockwise from magnetic north. Take runway 28 right. 28 indicates 280, or in this particular case, 280 degrees in direction. Always add a zero to the end. The R indicates that there is a left and a right. We could also have a C for center as well. Runway centerline markings. This is a white uniform line that goes down the length of the runway. It's about 120 feet long with 80-foot gaps in between them. Obviously, they're used to help align the aircraft for takeoff and landing. Touchdown zone markings. These markings are shown to help identify the touchdown zone of the aircraft. They're placed every 500 feet and are comprised of basically 1, 2, and 3 rectangular bars, arranged in pairs about the runway centerline. These markings are on both ends of the runway, for pairs which extend to within 900 feet of the midpoint between the thresholds are eliminated. Let's get to the fun part, aiming point. Okay, there are many names for the aiming point. 1,000-footers, boards, catching the 3-wire, we can go on and on. However, the proper term is, you guessed it, the aiming point. These are located 1,000 feet down the runway, and there are 2 rectangular markings consisting of a broad white stripe located on each side of the runway centerline, approximately 1,000 feet from the landing threshold. A perfect landing is to put your gear right in between these 2 markings. Actually, within the first third of the runway is what we want to shoot for. Displaced threshold. A displaced threshold is a threshold located at the point on the runway other than the designated beginning of the runway. Displacement of a threshold reduces the length of runway available for landings. The portion of runway behind a displaced threshold is available for takeoffs in either direction and landings from the opposite direction. A 10-foot wide threshold bar is located across the width of the runway at the displaced threshold. White arrows are located along the center line in the area between the beginning of the runway and the displaced threshold. White arrow heads are located across the width of the runway just prior to the threshold bar. As you can see, we just touched the surface of the runway markings and what to expect while you take off and land. We hope you enjoy your next landing. And remember to check out our products at navigraph.com.